So could you start off by introducing your company and giving me a bit of an overview of your application and your motivations behind creating it?
Sure. My company is called 280 North. We actually have two products that use the Google APIs. The first one is called 280 Slides. It's kind of like PowerPoint or Keynote on the web. And the other is an open source framework called Cappuccino for creating applications like 280 Slides.
So tell me a bit about how you chose to use the open web for your app.
Sure. I mean, it was pretty clear from the beginning that we wanted to do web-based applications since it's the best distribution platform there is. And the Google APIs in particular allowed us to use a lot of existing services. In particular, we use both Google Images and the YouTube APIs to allow people to bring in rich media into their slides and applications.
So do you have any war stories you can share with us?
Actually, interestingly enough, the war stories are not so much about the Google APIs in general, but having to use a number of APIs, because we also use like Flickr APIs, and obviously they're designed differently than the Google ones, so it was kind of unfortunate that we had to have kind of like two separate code bases. So oftentimes when we would use one set of APIs, we were thinking like the other ones, and then that would lead to some interesting stories. But
so if you could snap your fingers today and instantly have some sort of key web standard or feature available across all black browsers today, what would that be?
Canvas, easily. That's an easy question.
Why Canvas?
Because it's, I think, the last remaining component to fully being able to do just about anything from the desktop on the web. Just being able to have pixel level control completely changes the space.
So what part of HTML5 are you most excited about?
I think I'm most excited about, well, Canvas, but also web workers. I think, you know, the ability to have kind of threads is really exciting. Obviously, one of the big problems today is that the heavy JavaScript locks up the UI, and being able to put stuff off on a web worker is really exciting.
So how does what you're doing now fit into the open web?
So again, our main product is a web product, and the framework that we're developing is for developing applications on the open web, so they're kind of exactly aligned. And specifically, the reason we designed our framework is to allow people to use open standards and open technologies and have a solid framework such as .NET or Cocoa that they already have on the desktop, but on the web.
So where do you think the web should go in general? What are some significant problems that haven't been solved yet?
I would very much like to see a lot more low-level control. I think web workers and Canvas are a good start to this, but up to now, the trend with the web has been kind of enabling specific features as opposed to specific abilities. Like CSS has always been about, if you want to do this kind of layout, use this feature, as opposed to just having really low-level control, being able to do everything you can on the desktop.
So what do you most need from Ajax and HTML?
For it to get faster.
Faster,
yes. that's basically the number one thing we want.
That's cool. So have you learned anything at I.O. that you're really excited about?
Yeah, I mean, I got to learn a lot about the Android platform, which I actually didn't know anything about before, and I got a free phone, so I can actually start developing for it, and that's exciting. A lot of HTML5 stuff I got to learn more in depth. So
that's cool. Well, thank you for having me talk to
Thank you.